Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, I'm really glad that you made the decision to tune in today. This is going to be a particularly important worldwide transmission. One of controlled rage. I am so angry and so focused and so sure in my analysis of the globalist master plan that I am beside myself with concern and energy to resist these people. I am beside myself. The globalists are preparing, and we can back them off, to not just launch new, wider wars, but to also stage domestic terror attacks, blaming domestic groups, and publicly rolling out homeland security against the American people, which they've already begun to do after a decade of claiming it was for al-Qaeda, and then all the major operatives for al-Qaeda are on record working at the Pentagon. From Adam Gadon, grandson of the former head of the ADL, to Anwar al-Awlaki dining secretly with the Secretary of the Army. On record, Fox News Associated Press, to the underwear bomber drugged and put on the plane. And we, of course, broke that a month and a half before it was mainstream news. Because our people see something, they say something. And when they see government terrorists, they don't call the government terrorist. They call us. And so I'm going to give you real and credible threats, not, oh, we're taking all your rights away and going to stick our hands on your pants for an unspecified threat. I'm going to give you specified threats today. I'm going to tell you who the terrorists are. I'm going to tell you their past crimes, and I'm going to tell you their likely next targets, just like I did, but even in more detail, September 25th, 2001, and just like I did on 9/11, 1 month before it was made public, but I could tell it was already going on, because the enemy programs you out in the open. But if you are conscious and not hypnotized, you see the magician leading the hypnotized person around by the nose. I was able to say they're launching a bio attack to create fear and shut down the government. Even the ADL attacked me September 12th in an article titled What They're Saying, and enshrined not just my own audio, but in text that I had indeed said this. They were attacking me for it. Look at this insane person. He says a bio attack is being launched, and then it would be used to shut down the government. Exactly that happened. I know the enemy's mind. I study this so in depth that it's like looking out of their own eyes. And they're hesitating right now with different levers they can pull. So I'm not sure what lever they're going to pull, because they're watching us. What do we do? Before, we could just stage this and get away with it. Every time we stage it, they've got people watching. They're aware of us. You bet we are, killers. You murderers. You people that blew up the daycare center in Oklahoma City. People that get the underwear bomber on the plane. People that give Libya to al-Qaeda. You bet we see you, and we're fearless, and you don't know how to deal with it, do you? You're just going to launch some big wars, try to arrest some people, blow up some stuff, and dance around as saviors on TV, and then start trying to shut down the internet. We've got all these Obama advisors publicly saying, ban people off the web that say government-sponsored terror. You're going to ban Encyclopedia Britannica, stating that Operation Ajax was staged terror by the CIA MI6 against Iran as a pretext for war? What about declassified Operation Northwoods, ABC News, Associated Press? Going to shut them down? What about Encyclopedia Britannica on Gulf of Tonkin to get us into Vietnam, a staged terror attack? Going to shut them down, too? Look, the horse already left the barn, scum. You're already convicted worldwide, and we're just getting started. Now, I said it's controlled rage. Stay with us. Key announcement straight ahead. It is February 7th, 2012. This will be one of the most important broadcasts I have ever done. Coming up in about 15 minutes at Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com, an article that Paul Watson and I have been working on this morning that he's finishing up right now, will be posted to the websites. And it is a worldwide private sector media alert. InfoWars is going to issue a worldwide terrorism threat alert. Years before the State Department admitted that Mexico was one of the most dangerous countries in the world and that you shouldn't travel there, we could see the numbers of thousands of dead, hundreds of U.S. tourists every year, and tell you that even though they wouldn't issue the alert, that it's not safe. And when it became cartoonishly obvious with 40,000 dead or so in just a few years, hundreds and hundreds of U.S. citizens, kidnappings, murders, you name it, they finally issued those a couple years ago. So when the federal government, who's been caught, and we're going to have this in the article, issuing fake terror alerts in 2005 and then again in 2009, and Governor Ridge, the former head of Homeland Security 2 years ago, wrote a book about it, these are the terrorists. These are the people trying to scare us into submission to give up our Bill of Rights and Constitution. But when you look at it, they're the ones lying about WMDs to take us to war. That's a false flag terror, threatening us with those weapons that don't exist. That's the definition of terrorism. The definition of terrorism throughout history is to carry out violence or threaten violence so that populations will accept a political goal. And so you're told, give up your rights or the terrorist will kill you. That is terrorizing someone. Telling a child, be good or the boogeyman's going to get you. That's an old-fashioned way to make kids behave. What the old-timers did, telling them parables, Hansel and Gretel and things like that. That's terrorizing them. Telling a child, don't go swim in the water or a shark will eat you. That's terrorizing someone. And that's what the system does. They dance around going ooga booga. But here's the deal. With all of the preconditioning, the rollouts we're seeing, the media hype that I'm going to go over here in a moment, with all of this going on, with all of this happening, we are in a prime zone ahead of this war with Iran for staged terror in Europe, Israel, the United States, Asia, Africa, Latin America, you name it, as governments everywhere hire private corporations or hire terror groups, many of which are just mercenary groups, operating under different shadowy names, to stage attacks as pretext to get the population to go along with war and with the financial global consolidation, the global financial takeover that's taking place as the mega banks steal tens of trillions of dollars from taxpayers globally every year and have those governments sign over fraudulent, what they say is irrevocable control of their nations. All the big movements are happening. The political planets are aligning for global consolidation, open world government, giant wars bigger than just regional wars that the Rand Corporation called for to help bring in their New World Order 3 years ago. That PNAC, 11 years ago, September 20th, 2000, called for something as big as a Pearl Harbor event on American citizens, 3,000 dead, as a pretext to launch the wars. Read it. Rebuilding America's Defenses, September 20th, published, written about in the New York Times, Washington Post. I'm on radio talk shows with neocons sometimes, back when I had time to do it, you know, to come on and debate people. And I'd say, well, Dick Cheney wrote in PNAC, September 20th, 2000, Rebuilding America's Defenses, that they wanted to use race-specific bioweapons, have giant terror attacks as a pretext to launch wars, to take over Afghanistan, Iraq. And they'll say, shut up, conspiracy theorist. And I'd be, well, wait, just search it. Oh, yes, yeah, search it. I could find anything on the internet. And I'm like, no, it's Project for New American Century, PNAC.org. Please look it up. No, you're lying. And they, you know, get a collar on and go, why don't you just move in with the Taliban? Bet you work with Al-Qaeda. I'm like, Zbigniew Brzezinski, he's, you know, written two books admitting the U.S. government founded Al-Qaeda. The former Foreign Secretary of England went public about that and then died right after, saying it was totally staged. The former head of a German intelligence went public, Andre von Bülow. Oh, Mr. Bülow, going to tell me next about a Bilderhamburger? Well, no, Bilderberger's real. It's the global elite meeting. Ah, the global elite meeting. Yeah, the UN wants a global tax, global army. Go to UN, your own website. Oh, sure they do. You know, you people are. This is what we deal with. And we've shown you the memos in the last decade, now public. Before we'd get a Homeland Security document, a PNAC document, we'd be given it by a business owner, police officer, a federal marshal, a state police officer, FBI, people that are good inside the system and have seen that we're telling the truth that give us information. And, you know, I'd come out 4 years ago with a Homeland Security document and Ron Paul would get called and say, I don't know if that's real, we got to check. And then Homeland Security comes out and says, yeah, we do list Ron Paul, if you support him, that you may be a terrorist. Yeah, if you're a libertarian, we say you may be a terrorist. Yeah, it's real. And people are like, whoa, they're saying returning veterans and libertarians and nationalists and those that want to, quote, get out of the UN are terrorists? Wow. You know, and then it was every major show in the country not giving us credit, of course, for breaking all of that. And then we learned from listeners that they're training Boy Scouts to spy on their parents. People don't believe it. Then it comes out in the news and people are like, well, that's good. Then we get documents 3 years before it's brought out in mainstream media that they're training tens of thousands. Now it's hundreds of thousands of preachers to spy on their flocks. And people are like, oh, that can't be real. That's not America. Then it comes out and people are like, well, that's good. And then it turns out the coffee shops, the cable repair person, the telephone man, the water company, they're all in there. And now you see it when people are in your house, they'll chat you up and they'll start asking you questions. What's this? What's that? Oh, I see you're growing some plants here. You know, what kind of plant's this? It's a jade plant. And I'm like, what, are you trying to see if I'm doing something illegal? Well, we just ask. Oh, we just ask. And then see, now it's all admitted because it's going mainline. It's going mainline everywhere. And so, coming up at the bottom of the hour, I am going to focus and give you a detailed analysis breakdown on what we're facing. And I just got chills. And I'm risking my life to do this. Believe me, the globalists do not like what we're doing here. That's why they're openly talking about censoring us by name. Okay? Yeah, there's the New York Times. First line of the article. Scouts trained to fight terrorists and more. First line of the article. They trained to take out an Iraq war vet. People laughed and said, well, they're 14-year-olds. This is from 3 years ago. They're now 17. You ever heard of the Hitler Jugend? You know, the Soviets did that. It's not about the...